You are welcome to brain classes. Today we are going to discuss about the pancreas. Pancreas is an elongated organ which is present in the C-shaped arrangement of the duodenum. Now focus on this slide. In which slide, pancreas is directly connected to the duodenum. That part is the pancreas, and that structure is the duodenum. The pancreas is directly connected to the duodenum in the C-shape arrangement. And next is pancreas having a head, body and tail. The head part is the directly attached to the duodenum, that is head portion of pancreas. The middle portion of pancreas is called body, that is body of pancreas. And the last portion of the pancreas is called tail. Okay, that is tail. Okay, so that pancreas is elongated organ which is present in the C-shaped arrangement of the duodenum, and it having a head, body and tail. Now next is pancreas is double gland. Pancreas is a double gland. It is exocrine portion and endocrine portion. Okay. Now, firstly, we describe about exocrine portion of the pancreas. The pancreas having a pancreatic duct. That green structure. This is pancreatic duct. Okay, the duct is pancreatic duct. The pancreatic duct produce a digestive enzyme. This duct produce digestive enzyme, and this duct having some acinies. And suppose these are acinies, and look like that. Acinies are and rounded shape structure. Suppose these are acinies. Acinies are teeny rounded shape structure which is present in the pancreas and secrete the digestive enzyme. Digestive enzyme in the pancreatic duct, which release into the lumen of the duodenum. Okay, and now next is endocrine portion of the pancreas. Endocrine portion consists of group of cells which called islets of Langerhans. Now there are some cells groups. These types rounded shapes, these are islets of Langerhans. Islets of Langerhans. Okay, these are islets of Langerhans. These are different type of pancreatic and endocrine cells which are clumped together and distributed within the mass of pancreas. These cells secrete insulin, glucagon and somatostatin hormone. They secretion directly into the blood, so this is called endocrine portion of the pancreatic gland. Now look, एट द फर्स्ट ऑफ द टॉक अबाउट द पेनक्रियाटिक डग पेनक्रियाटिक रिलेशनशिप पेनक्रियाटिक डक्ट विद बाइल डक्ट सिस्टम नाउ शोविंग दिस इज ए पेनक्रियाटिक डक्ट विच डायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड टू द विच डायरेक्टली कनेक्टेड टू द बाइल डक्ट सिस्टम हियर ए नाउ देर आर ए लीवर ओके लीवर एंड लीवर हैज ए राइट हेपेटिक डक्ट एंड लेफ्ट हेपेटिक डक्ट This is right hepatic duct. There are right hepatic duct and there are left hepatic duct. Right and left hepatic duct join the common bile duct. Now focus on this diagram. Right and left hepatic duct join a common bile duct. There are a common bile duct. Now the point is common bile duct. Okay. Common bile duct. Here the gallbladder. Now next is gallbladder. Showing you gallbladder. It is a gallbladder. The gallbladder. It is direct. Gallbladder having a cystic duct. Okay, cystic duct. And common hepatic duct. They common together make a common bile duct. Cystic duct and right hepatic duct, left hepatic duct, common bile duct and cystic duct make a common bile duct. Which come down and move behind the first part of the duodenum. Common bile duct is move down and going behind the first part of duodenum and eventually goes to the pancreas and now then it is directly goes to the pancreas there are now going to the pancreas and enter into the pancreatic substance okay now enter into the pancreatic substance with into the common bile duct fuse with the pancreatic duct and they make major pancreatohepatic ampulla pancreatic duct and common bile duct make a this portion is there are common bile duct and pancreatic duct are attached with together and form a common duct which is called pancreatohepatic duct pancreatohepatic duct okay common bile duct and pancreatic duct fuse together and form a pancreatic hepato duct and open into the lumen of the duodenum now there are hepatopancreatic ampulla pancreatohepatic duct is open into the duodenum at the point of the hepatopancreatic ampulla. This portion is hepatopancreatic ampulla. Okay, hepatopancreatic ampulla, and there are a sphincter present which is called duodenal papillae, which help in the entering the bile. And pancreatic substance into the duodenum for the digestion and digestion absorption of the nutrient substance. Okay, this slide is complete. This slide about the pancreatic duct, right hepatic duct, left hepatic duct, common bile duct, cystic duct, common bile duct, and hepatopancreatic ampulla. That is complete. Now next is general anatomy of the pancreas. Okay, the color of the pancreas is creamy pink. The weight of the pancreas, the normal weight of the pancreas in the human, adult human is the length of the pancreas is 12 to 15 centimeter, and the location is the location of the pancreas is the epigastric and left hypogastric region of the abdominal cavity. Okay. Now next is parts of the pancreas, means that it exocrine part of the pancreas, head, body and tail. Now that is a general structure of the pancreas, which is directly connected to the gallbladder and spleen. Now next, head. The head is a broad part of the pancreas. It lies in the curve of the duodenum. Now next is body. The pancreatic body is lie behind the stomach, and it is the largest part of the pancreas. And tail, it is a narrow and the last part of the pancreas. It lies in front of the left kidney and just reaching the spleen. And neck. Now next is exocrine pancreatic detail. I firstly explain you about the pancreas, exocrine pancreas and endocrine pancreas. Now again I explain in the theoretical form. This consists of a large number of lobules made up of small acini. Means that the exocrine pancreas having a large number of lobules. In the lobules, small acini is present, which secrete the digestive enzyme in the pancreatic duct. Each lobule is drained by a tiny duct, and these eventually unite to form the pancreatic duct. The lobules in the exocrine pancreas, many lobules present, and each lobule is drained by tiny ducts, and these unite to form a pancreatic duct and help in the formation of the pancreatic duct, which extend along the whole length of the gland and open into the duodenum, which is which is present in the whole pancreas and open into the duodenum. Into just before entering the duodenum, the pancreatic duct join the common bile duct and to form hepatopancreatic duct. I firstly explain you about the hepatopancreatic duct. The duodenal opening, the ampulla is controlled by the hepatopancreatic sphincter at the duodenal papillae. The duodenal opening means that the duodenal opening is opening. The ampulla is controlled by the hepatopancreatic sphincter, which is present at the duodenal and pancreatic opening. The function of the exocrine pancreas is to produce digestive juice. The important function of the exocrine pancreas is to produce pancreatic juice, which is help in the digestion of the food. Now next is pancreatic juice. The pancreatic juice secreted by the exocrine pancreas and enter into the duodenum at the duodenal papillae. It consists of water, mineral, salt, enzyme like amylase, lipase, nucleates, trypsinogen, chemotrypsinogen. Okay, chemotrypsinogen is secreted by the duodenum, and the pH of the pancreatic juice is about at 8. It is slightly acidic. The important function of the pancreatic juice is digestion of carbohydrate, fat and protein. Okay, now next is blood supply of the pancreas. The arterial blood supply, splenic and mesenteric artery supply the pancreas, and the venous drainage is by the portal vein. Thank you for watching the video, and now subscribe, like, share the video. Okay, thank you.